About 71% of Earth's surface is covered by water, and this vast mass is in constant motion. While we talk about the revolutions of solar and wind power, there is another force that often escapes our attention, or worse, gets underestimated: the rhythmic power of the oceans. According to the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, ocean waves carry an annual energy potential of about 29,500 terawatt hours, nearly 10 times Europe's yearly electricity consumption. Unlike wind energy, wave energy stores the power of the wind 1,000 times more intensely, thanks to the immense density of the ocean's water mass. Water, being approximately 1,000 times denser than air, allows even relatively small devices to achieve very high energy flux densities. The International Renewable Energy Agency estimates that 500 gigawatts of technical capacity can be harnessed by using just 2% of the world's coastline. The U.S. Department of Energy, on the other hand, states that the annual wave energy potential along U.S. coasts could meet 63% of the country's grid-scale electricity needs. This potential makes wave energy a perfect complement to wind and solar power. Why? Because waves, unlike wind and sun, are more predictable and more continuous. In fact, the oceans are essentially our planet's gigantic, natural battery. So, despite this enormous potential, why are they not as common as wind turbines and solar panels? Why have previous projects in this field failed to meet expectations? And most importantly, what has changed now? Wave energy research has been ongoing since the mid-20th century, but until now, it has only achieved small-scale commercial success. The first serious interest in wave power began after the oil crisis in the 1970s. For example, Stephen Salter's device, developed in the 1970s, called the Salter's Duck, was one of the earliest and most efficient examples of wave energy. However, high development costs and technological difficulties halted the progress of this and many similar projects. In the 2000s, various technologies such as Pelamys, Wave Dragon, and Aquamarine Oyster were tested in Europe and Japan. Although these devices improved conversion efficiency and durability, they did not achieve widespread commercialization. The general consensus attributes this to the corrosive nature of seawater, extreme wave and storm conditions, lack of sufficient funding, and regulatory uncertainty. In 2020, estimates for the levelized cost of energy for wave energy were around 57 cents per kilowatt hour on average. This cost was too high to compete with fossil fuels and established renewable energy sources. The main drivers of this high cost are high installation and maintenance expenditures, coupled with frequent breakdowns in the challenging marine environment. These experiences laid the groundwork for the sector to learn and move towards next-generation solutions. Researchers who are now looking at wave energy with renewed hope are developing more innovative designs and technologies to overcome these challenges. There are now many different wave energy converter concepts: floating point absorbers, shore-fixed systems, giant swinging arms, and seabed-mounted flapping devices. EcoWave Power develops shore-adjacent wave energy solutions. The company generates electricity from wave motion using floating panels installed on coastal walls. In 2025, EcoWave Power opened the first U.S. land-based wave energy power plant at the Port of Los Angeles. This open-air trial was a significant step demonstrating EcoWave's technology infrastructure. For example, California Senator Nanette Barragan supported this project and called for a $1 billion investment in wave energy across the U.S. EcoWave's CEO, Ina Braverman, also notes that new projects are already planned in Taiwan, India, and Portugal. AW Energy is known for its submerged wave converter model called Wave Roller. Wave Roller consists of giant vertical flaps mounted on a platform fixed parallel to the shore. Waves push these flaps back and forth, powering hydraulic pumps. The company recently signed a contract for a 2-megawatt wave farm off the coast of Portugal. As the European Union targets 1 gigawatt of installed capacity in wave energy, firms like AW Energy are making serious investments in this area. CalWave is a groundbreaking US-based company in the wave energy sector. Its X-Wave technology operates entirely underwater, unlike many other converters that float on the surface. The device captures pressure changes caused by ocean waves, flexing like the seafloor and converting that motion into electricity. When it detects strong storms, it submerges deeper to protect itself from destructive surface conditions. CalWave's mission is to deliver the ocean's most consistent power to electric grids in a cost-effective and reliable way. The company reached a major milestone with its successful 10-month pilot project off the coast of San Diego, California's first long-duration open-ocean wave energy trial. During the test, the X-Wave unit survived two major storms and maintained 99% operational uptime, proving its exceptional reliability and commercial potential. Now, let's turn to CorPower, the reason for making this video. CorPower uses a type of point absorber wave energy converter that floats on the surface, connected to the seabed by a tensioned tether system. This system generates power by drawing energy from both the up and down and back and forth motion of the waves. CorPower's biggest difference is that its design is inspired by the working principle of the human heart. Just as the heart adjusts itself according to the incoming pressure and efficiently pumps blood, the CorPower device adapts to the rhythm of the waves. The goal is to create a system that is both lightweight, durable, and highly efficient. At the heart of CorPower's technology is an innovative system called the WaveSpring Phase Control System. This system allows the device to react to the rhythm of the waves at precisely the right time. That means the buoy moves most efficiently when the wave reaches its peak. This, in turn, exponentially increases energy production. While a 1 meter wave would normally move the buoy by 1 meter, the WaveSpring allows this movement to increase up to 3 meters. This resonance effect can increase the device's annual energy production by approximately 300%. This translates to more energy with smaller devices. The biggest problem with wave energy projects has always been the same: ocean storms. When waves reached 15 to 20 meters, surface devices could suffer significant damage. CorPower solved this problem with a detuning mechanism. This system automatically changes the device's operational mode when a storm approaches. The buoy becomes more transparent to incoming waves, meaning it moves with the waves instead of absorbing their energy. Inside the buoy, a pneumatic pretension system keeps the unit stable without requiring massive ballast weights. Together, these features make the device both light and naturally storm-resistant, potentially cutting capital costs by up to 40%. CorPower's design is much more compact compared to other wave energy devices. A volume 10 times smaller can be sufficient to produce the same amount of energy. For example, a 300 kilowatt CorPower device is only 9 meters by 18 meters in size and weighs approximately 60 tons. Other wave systems generating the same power can be hundreds of meters long and weigh thousands of tons. This difference significantly reduces transportation, installation, and maintenance costs. Furthermore, smaller devices are much more advantageous for mass production and commercial scaling. CorPower Ocean has passed a significant threshold in the history of wave energy with its High Wave 5 project, conducted off the coast of Agucedura, Portugal. The goal of this project was to make wave energy a bankable energy source, meaning one that financial institutions could confidently invest in between 2027 and 2028. Within this scope, CorPower tested its full-scale device, the C4, in the open sea. The results obtained were transformative, not just for the company, but for the entire wave energy sector. CorPower's C4 device successfully weathered major storms like Storm Babé and Storm Align off the coast of Portugal. Wave heights reached 13 meters during these storms, and the device was even exposed to the highest recorded value of 18.5 meter waves. Even under these extreme conditions, the device's movement was limited to just a few decimeters. The system's detuning feature proved its worth. The C4 tests were not limited to durability. The device successfully transmitted power to Portugal's national electricity grid with a peak power generation of 600 kilowatts. This value shows that wave energy is no longer just a laboratory idea, but has become operational in the real world. Environmental impacts were closely monitored throughout all phases of the High Wave 5 project. No negative effects were detected on ocean flora and fauna. However, long-term observations will provide a clearer picture of the technology's overall environmental impact. The commercial proliferation of wave energy depends on reducing its production cost. In 2020, the average cost of wave energy was around 57 cents per kilowatt hour. However, research institutions, particularly National Renewable Energy Laboratory, predict that this figure could drop dramatically in the coming years. Although wave energy has entered a period of technical maturation, there are still some practical issues that need to be resolved. One of the most significant challenges is how the devices are connected to the seabed. Establishing a separate mooring system for each device quickly increases costs in large wave farms. Therefore, researchers are working on shared mooring systems. With this method, multiple devices can be connected to a single anchoring system. Analyses show that this can reduce costs by up to 60%. It also decreases the impact on the seabed and the installation time. Wave energy, like solar and wind, is a variable resource. However, This variability can lead to voltage and frequency imbalances in electricity grids. Therefore, energy storage solutions and smart grid management systems are critically important. Thanks to new control algorithms, wave energy devices can be optimized to produce energy when it is most needed. This makes grid integration smoother. CorPower Ocean's vision is to establish the world's first commercial wave energy farm between 2026 and 2028. If this goal is successfully completed, waves could shape not just the coasts, but also the future of the energy sector. Significant developments are also taking place across the sector. Focus has shifted from individual prototypes to multi-device arrays and grid integration, allowing systems to function together like large power plants. At the same time, wave energy is beginning to be used not only for electricity generation, but also in new areas such as desalination and powering offshore vehicles. These developments show that the sector is rapidly maturing. Market research also indicates strong optimism for the future. Data from Precedence Research suggests that the wave and tidal energy market will grow at an annual rate of 9.1% between 2025 and 2034. Grandview Research forecasts a much more ambitious rate, predicting a 32.9% CAGR. According to this growth rate, by 2050, wave energy could be one of the main components of the energy mix, not just a small part. All these developments have one common result. The power of the ocean is no longer just an idea. It is an engineering reality. Wave energy stands out alongside wind and solar as a continuous and predictable energy source. These systems, which operate non-stop even at night, bring stability to the clean energy mix. If our goal is truly a fossil fuel independent future, wave energy is a strong candidate to be one of the silent yet powerful engines of this transformation. The world is currently witnessing the birth of a new energy giant rising from the oceans. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel for similar videos. See you in the next video.